number 250.
तो हमने सोचा कि इस कार्यक्रम को एक फॉर्मल ना करते हुए एक पर्सनल पारिवारिक करें स्मृति जी के सामने. तो हमने सोचा कि जो सूत्रधार
किसी भी कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत हमारे में कहा गया है तमसो मा ज्योतिर्जन अस्तो दूसरी जिंदगी से हर दुख को निवारण करना हो तो कहीं ना कहीं रोशनी होनी चाहिए, चाहे हमारे मन के अंदर की अंधकार उसको हटाना स्वच्छ हमारे रूप कुछ भी नहीं. जब ज्योति है, जब रोशनी है, जब उजाला है, तभी काम शुरुआत. उसी बात
अवकाश के दिन, छुट्टी के दिन आप लोग समय निकाल कर इस समारोह की शोभा बढ़ाने आए हैं. मैं मन से आप सबके प्रति आभार व्यक्त करता हूं, अभिनंदन करता हूं, आपका वंदन करता हूं. बहुत बहुत स्वागत आपका, बहुत धन्यवाद.
Dr Krishna Saksena, who is writing even at the age of 91 and going to be now 92. And of course with us we also have the wonderful and Smriti Irani, whom is an honorable minister today, heads two ministries, and I'm a huge admirer of hers, because not only recently as she has got this khitab of being a giant killer, but she has also been doing wonderful work. Smriti ji, you have broken many glass ceilings, and one thing which is common between you and Krishna ji is that you both started your life from a very ordinary background and then grew on to do extraordinary things. And I think that deserves a round of applause. And another thing I would like to state right at the beginning about Smriti ji is that finally we do have a minister who represents the diversity and different cultures of India in the way she dresses as Minister of Textiles, and also represents the strength of Indian women in the other ministry which she heads of Women and Child Development. So another round of applause for her. Thank you, Priti Srivastava, for organizing this function to commemorate Dr. Krishna Saksena. Om Soul, which you have set up, is also symbolic of the occasion today, because you take shapeless rocks and convert them into very beautiful products, which is wonderful. And not only that, you use all the money that comes in from this work that you do, and you support people who are who are unable to go to school on their own, and you support many such very, very wonderful charitable organizations. So congratulations for that, along with your husband, of course. And because behind every successful Indian mother, there is a very loving son, I would like to thank Sri Shankar Saksena for acknowledging his mother's contributions. And I think that is really wonderful. Shankar is Adab. Sorry, I correct myself. Dr. Krishna Saksena, what can I say about you? You are extremely unusual. I feel I know you deeply because I have been reading your books, which you have written with such great honesty. But today, as an author myself, writing on gender, I would like your blessing so that one day I can also achieve what you have achieved, an impossible dream, I think, for many of us, writing books at the age of 92. Thank you so much for doing this. Dr. Saksena is also unique because of the kind of writing that she has done. She has written over the years on subjects dear to her, whether fiction or non-fiction, whether academic or physical or spiritual themes. But then she has always been a rule breaker. To begin with, the first woman to receive a PhD in Uttar Pradesh in English literature in 1955. So that is really something. And this for me is very interesting because it shows how education can change the perception of people towards you. We often talk about financial security for women, Smriti ji, but in Dr. Saxena's case, we see that it has transformed, education has transformed her life in so many ways. Because firstly, it brought her fame, then marriage, yes, that was also one of the consequences of her PhD. Then an academic career, and ultimately her second career as an author. It also enabled her to assist her family where required, and undoubtedly also plays a big role in the philanthropy that she does. She has built a huge Devi Mandir at Bhavana near Delhi, where she is empowering the village women and has also become an enabler to counsel them to take jobs. She has even counseled the youth and criminals. She is a really courageous woman. There is also a family-run ashram in Vrindavan where free medical services are given to the poor. It includes a gaushala, and she has adopted 25 girls for village education. And if I'm not mistaken, one of them is now working with Hema Malini, the actor as well as the MP. Therefore, we clearly see that the two lodestones of her life are her education, on the one hand, and her spirituality, which contribute in large measure to her writing. Both enable her to move forward with courage and not lose hope. Let me explain with a few examples. Let's look at how important education can be, even when it comes to marriage, as I mentioned. In 1955, when she was 28 years old, her younger sisters were married before her, and this became a point of sadness for her. But her parents remained supportive. Her father...
मैं सोच रहा था ये आंटी को इस क्या कहना चाहिए तो मेरे दिमाग में एक वर्ड आया द बिलियनर इंटेलेक्चुअल क्या सोचेंगे ये क्या वर्ड है पहली बात तो ये है कि 90 साल तक कौन पहुंच पाता है बड़ा मुश्किल काम है 90 साल तक पहुंचना 90 के बाद इतना एक्टिव रहना ये भी बहुत मुश्किल है उस एक्टिव रहने के बाद अपने मन को संतुलित रखते हुए पूरे परिवार को देखना अपना रोज का काम करना 3 घंटे पूजा करना सबका ध्यान रखना किसने खाना खाया कि नहीं खाया और उसके बाद अपनी यादों को संजो करके एक बेहतरीन किताब लिखना ये 1 खरब में एक ही व्यक्ति कर सकता है कि नहीं कोई आप कल धारण है क्या था 1 खरब यानी बिलियनर इसलिए मैंने कहा कि 1 खरब में कोई ऐसा बुद्धिजीवी है जिसने काम करके दिखाया इसलिए मैंने उनका नाम रखा है एक बार ताली तो बनती है मेरे कहने पे भी